Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. The lowly servant here. Welcome to my channel. Today is February 27, 2021, Saturday of the first week of Lent. The Gospel said, "So be perfect, just as your heavenly Father is perfect." Let's have a listen and reflect on it after. The first reading is from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people, saying, "This day the Lord, your God, commands you to observe these statutes and decrees. Be careful, then, to observe them with all your heart and with all your soul. Today you are making this agreement with the Lord. He is to be your God and you are to walk in His ways and observe His statutes, commandments and decrees, and to hearken to His voice. And today the Lord is making this agreement with you. You are to be a people peculiarly His own, as He promised you. And provided you keep all His commandments, He will then raise you high in praise and renown and glory above all other nations He has made. And you will be a people sacred to the Lord, your God, as He promised." Responsorial Psalm. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Blessed are they whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are they who observe His decrees, who seek Him with all their heart. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. You have commanded that your precepts be diligently kept. Oh, that I might be firm in the ways of keeping your statutes. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. I will give you thanks with an upright heart. When I have learned your just ordinances, I will keep your statutes. Do not utterly forsake me. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Verse before the Gospel. Behold, now is a very acceptable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. The Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to His disciples, "You have heard that it was said, 'You shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy.' But I say to you, love your enemies, and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your heavenly Father. For He makes His sun rise on the bad and the good, and causes rain to fall on the just and the unjust. For if you love those who love you, what recompense will you have? Do not the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet your brothers and sisters only, what is unusual about that? Do not the pagans do the same? So be perfect, just as your heavenly Father is perfect." Reflection. The greatest scandal of Christianity today is that the qualities for which that small community at Antioch were given the name Christian are no longer found amongst many so-called Christian communities today. Basically, there seems to be no line of distinction today between Christians, non-believers, agnostics and even atheists, other than the fact that each Sunday, we go to church. What made that first community so unique? What earned them the name Christian? It was the Christ-like love that existed among them. A love that is capable of forgiving one's enemies right on the cross, a love that does not select its beneficiaries, a love that is purely sacrificial, not expecting anything in return. In all honesty, the only love found in our so-called Christian communities today is the business love. A love that is purely based on give and take. A love that is concerned only about those who are capable or willing to reciprocate it. A love that demands much more than it gives. A selective love. We say we are Christians, yet we fight each other just as non-believers do, sometimes even bloodier than non-believers. We drag even present our cases before traditional rulers, some of whom do not share our faith. In truth, if the people of that community at Antioch behaved like us, they wouldn't have been called Christians but simply churchgoers. What makes us Christians? It is our ability to rise above the traditional churchgoer mentality. It is doing more than the tax collectors who love only those that love them. It is doing more than the Gentiles who greet only those that greet them. It is stepping out of the box, is acting in a manner that is really different from what our society regards as normal. It is doing things just as Jesus would do if he were to walk this earth again. Being a Christian is practicing what I would call non-selective goodness. It is being kind to people not because they deserve it but because of who you are. A child whose father does not discriminate who to benefit or not from his reign. That's the end of the reflection from the Catholic Missal. Subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell, so you won't miss out on my next upload. Be safe and always keep God in your hearts. Peace to all.